Hi everyone, my name is Ivan and I want to welcome you to my vlog. And it's all about balls, and I mean basketballs, volleyballs, soccer balls and every other kind of sport that uses balls. First of all, in this episode, I'm gonna talk about inflating a ball the right way. Because sometimes I also see people do it the wrong way, with a dry needle, for example, and also a dry valve. And of course, after a couple of months, or maybe a couple of weeks, the ball is getting flat. So we have the perfect solution for it, and I'm gonna explain it in this video. So welcome to my vlog. First of all, let's talk about the equipment we're gonna use to inflate the balls. The first thing we need, of course, is a pump to inflate the ball, because otherwise it's gonna be maybe a little bit more difficult. It doesn't matter what kind of pump you use. The most important thing is use a pump that doesn't have too much pressure, because otherwise you're gonna overinflate the ball, and that's also not good for the valve and for the ball itself. The second thing you need, of course, is a needle. The most important thing about the needle is that it doesn't have a sharp edge. Because of that sharp edge and you insert it into the valve, there's also a big chance that you're gonna maybe puncture the valve as well. So, most important thing about the needle is it has a smooth edge. Then it's also a lot better for the valve. And of course, also the third thing, and for me, the most important thing is oil, because some people want to inflate the ball when the valve is still dry, and of course then you're gonna puncture it. So the best thing to use is a very thin oil, and Select, also a big sports company, has a special kind of oil that you can use to inflate the balls. It's very thin and it's also not abrasive, so that's perfect if you want to insert it in the valve. The fourth thing that we need is a pressure gauge. Of course, you want to know what the pressure of the ball really is. And when it comes to volleyball, the pressure has to be between 0.3 and 0.33 bars. So it's a really thin margin. So it's, of course, always better to have a pressure gauge. For me, I prefer a digital one, because then you can clearly see what the pressure really is. With an analog one, it's a little bit more difficult, because sometimes the meter is not 100% perfect. And the last thing we need, of course, is a ball. Yeah, because otherwise we can't check the pressure, and I also cannot explain how exactly it all works. I've chosen the MVA 200 from Mikasa. It's the most used ball in the world. Definitely here in Belgium, it's used in almost everything, in every competition. In the rest of Europe, I also think it's Mikasa, the world championship, everything is with Mikasa balls. Also already with the new one, the V200W, but this is the old one, so the MVA 200 from Mikasa, and this is the ball we are gonna use. The first thing that I did was, of course, deflating the ball so that I could show you how to correctly inflate the ball. I also use Select valve oil to lubricate the valve. I put a few drops of oil in the valve and then I start to gently insert the needle. When I feel an obstruction, I make sure that I'm very careful and don't put the needle in further. I go back and forward, and by doing this, the oil seeps in a little bit better. When you do this a couple of times, you will feel no resistance at all, and then the valve is perfectly lubricated. Then, of course, I clean the valve with a paper tissue. And as you can see, the ball has been deflated a little bit, so that I can now start to reinflate the ball again. Here is also a close-up of the Select valve oil, and I will now put another few drops of oil in the valve. Apologies that my hands look a bit dry on camera, but it's because of the cold weather here in Belgium. And now, of course, I will use the ball pump to re-inflate the ball again. I use the Mikasa AP2. It has a compression cylinder, so there is not too much pressure going into the ball. You will also notice how easy it is to insert the needle into the valve. There is no brute force needed because the inside of the valve is lubricated sufficiently. You also hear a small popping sound coming out of the valve because of the oil. First, I check manually with my fingers what the pressure of the ball feels like. Then I use the Mikasa AG500 digital ball gauge. You see that the pressure is a bit too high. It's 0.36 bar and it has to be between 0.3 and 0.33. So I release a bit of the pressure by pressing the release valve. Afterwards, I clean the ball with a clean paper tissue and we are all finished. The ball is good for another couple of months. So this was my explanation how to properly inflate a ball, to inflate it the right way. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope also you learned something from it. If you have questions, just post it down in the comment. Also, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also push the alarm bell so you can also get notifications if I post another post. Thank you for watching and maybe see you next time. Bye!